गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, माय नेम इज़ मंगलम अग्रवाल। इन द यस्टरडे क्लास आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द कैनाल ब्रिजेस, इन विच वी डिस्कस अबाउट वेरियस रीजंस फॉर द कैनाल ब्रिजेस एंड देयर रेमेडियल एक्शंस टू बी टेकन, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ द इरिगेशन कैनाल। बट वी नो दैट ड्यू टू द कॉन्स्टेंट यूज ऑफ द कैनाल सिस्टम द कैनाल बैंक्स डैमेज विद द कोर्स ऑफ द टाइम। सो फेलियर्स मे बी फिजिकल और द फंक्शनल। So we take some preventive measures like the strengthening of the canal bank, in which we discuss various methods how to resolve this matter. The first one is the internal silting method. Okay, so now in the internal silting method, in this condition, when the banks of the canal section are in the fully filting, the banks are subjected to the water pressure. Okay, under this condition, it is essential to strengthen the canal bank. As the banks are constructed with the soil, the extra strength can be gained by increasing the section of the bank. In this condition, we just increase the section of the bank by increasing their strength. How can we increase their strength? By increasing their section. In order to keep the cost of the construction low, additional soil for increasing the bank section may be dried for the natural process of the silting internally. Okay, due to the high construction cost, we use the soil for increasing the bank section, due to which its cost of construction is reduced. This method is known as the internal silting method. By internal process, the soil is constructed to increase the canal section. So this method is known as the internal silting method. Okay, so this is the diagram of the internal silting method. Okay, please note that the sufficient wider section provided. Okay, so this is about the internal silting method. Now we proceed with one more method, which is the external silting method. Okay guys, so what is the external silting method? In this condition, we just hold the water externally in a confined portion, okay, by compartments or the silting tank in which the canal water is allowed into the compartment tanks, and after the detaining the water canal from the outlet, the silt load of the water deposit in the silting tank. Okay, so after the some spouts are also constructed to increase the silting rate. Okay, so let us see this, what is the internal silting method. In this method, it is essential to bring the flow of the water out of the canal section. To hold the water externally in a confined portion, subsidiary banks are required. Okay, subsidiary means secondary banks are required. Hence, these banks are made parallel to the main banks. The next point is the cross embankments are constructed within the two parallel banks to form the compartment or the silting tank. Okay, and each tank has an inlet and the outlet, and the inlet should be at the upstream end. Inlet should be at the upstream end, and the outlet should be at the downstream end of the tank. Okay, the canal water is allowed to get into the compartment through the inlet of the bank. After detaining the water for some time in the compartment, okay, it is taken back into the canal bank from the outlet. During the detention period, the silt load of the water deposit into the silting tank, and the silting tank gets filled with the silt. Therefore, the bank is strengthened by providing the additional mass externally. Okay, please note that the permeable spouts are constructed in the silting tank to increase the silting rate. Okay, so this is about the external silting method. Okay, let us take one more method to increase the strength of the canal bank, that is the formation of the berms by the internal silting. This is the external silting method representation. Okay, this is the cross embankment diagram, sectional elevation. Okay guys, so now we take the formation of the berm by the internal silting. Banks can also be strengthened by formation of the berm by the internal silting method. The silting of the berm can be accelerated by constructing the permeable spouts from the side of the canal section. I have just previous example like the external silting method. Just the what is the berm? This is known as the berm. Okay, this is about the canal embankment, and this portion, this horizontal distance, is known as the berm. Okay, so the banks can also be strengthened by the formation of the berm by the internal silting. The silting of the berm can be accelerated by constructing the permeable spouts from the side of the canal section. Okay, and the next method is the provision of the pushta or cover to the saturation line. When a saturation line passes out of the canal bank, a cover is provided. Then the saturation line meets the base within the limits of the bank. It makes the bank safe and the stable. So that is, it provides the more flexibility or the rigid portion to the bank. So these are the some methods by which we strengthen the canal bank. And some more examples like the aquatic weed control, silt removal, maintenance of the service road. These are some more methods like the aquatic weed control. Aquatic weeds are the unwanted plants that grow in the water under the sun favorable conditions. These weeds create the hindrance to the flow of the water. If the weeds are large, then the canal distance reduced by the 10-15%. Okay, weed growth can be prevented by removing the plants mechanically. Means okay. Another way of weed control is to rush rotation. It consists in running the canal with the full supply discharge for a required period of the time and then entirely closing the discharge. So this is about the weed control, aquatic weed control. The next method is the silt removal. In the silt removal, the silt load is prevented from entering the canal at its head. Naturally, some silt load present in the canal water which settles on the canal bed and the sides. Hence, deform the shape of the channel and changes the flow condition also. Therefore, silt ejector and the silt escapes are majorly used for the silt removal process. Okay, we also use the maintenance of the service road. In this condition, it includes the removal of the grass, leveling of the roads, surfacing of the road and all. The slope, if damaged, should be repaired to facilitate the drainage of the road. So guys, this is about the various methods in which we discuss how to provide the strengthening of the canal bank. Okay, so you can write from there how to provide the strengthening of the canal bank. This is also a part of the canal bridges in which we provide the strength of the canal bank. You can write. Okay guys, this is the external silting method. This is the external silting method. This is full supply level, FSL. Guys, so in the next video we will start a new unit . Thank you guys.